In this video, I'll be covering everything you need to know about merge and rebase and when and why you might want to use one over the other. We've got animations, we've got live coding samples, we've got common merge and rebase scenarios. Essentially, we've got your definitive guide right here. So let's first start with merging in this merge versus rebase showdown. Say you're working on a project and you split off from mainline to work on a feature branch. Maybe a coworker also pushes changes to mainline in the meantime. Now, once that feature is complete and tested, I'm going to be ready to merge my changes back onto that mainline branch. To do this, I'll just hop over into my terminal and make sure I have my main branch selected. Then I'll run git merge feature branch to tell Git that I'd like to bring that branch over onto my currently selected branch, which is main. Git will pop open my default terminal text editor. By default, it's going to be Vim, and allow me to add a descriptive message to that merge commit. I can either press I to enter insert mode and type my message, but I'll just leave it as it is for now. Then I'm going to press escape colon WQ, hit enter, and that'll save that merge message. The result is what's called a three-way merge, because not only are we merging our branch with mainline, we're also taking into account any changes that were introduced in the meantime. A three-way merge results in a merge commit that weaves together the tips of both branches, here and here, and takes into account their common ancestor here to resolve any conflicts that may have caught between the tips of both of those branches. One, two, three, and that's a three-way merge. Now, this example is probably the one you're most familiar with if you've used merge before, but just like rebase, at its core, merge's job is to integrate changes from one branch to another. And that doesn't always have to be one-directional. If I rewind here, let's say I'd like to incorporate the changes introduced by that new commit into my feature branch without actually merging my branch back onto mainline. This would be useful if I wanted to make sure my work was compatible with the latest changes, but I still had more work to do on my feature before moving it back over. This time, instead of checking out my main branch, I'll go ahead and check out my feature branch. Next, I'll run git merge main. Git will pop open that default terminal text editor again, and I'll optionally provide a merge commit message. I'll then run escape colon WQ just like before, hit enter, and the result will be that same three-way merge commit, but it'll be placed on the tip of my feature branch instead of the tip of main. And with that, my feature branch has integrated those latest changes, but still remains functionally separate from that shared mainline branch. A quick note about this workflow, every time new changes are pushed and integrated, another merge commit will be created. Plus, once you're ready to merge that feature, another merge commit will be created on top of main, on top of all those other ones. Now, this looks a little bit messy, but one thing to point out with merge is that we're always flowing forward in time. We're taking into account what happened in the past and adding to it, but we're never changing history. This non-destructive nature is a benefit of merge, but is it always a positive? Hold on to that thought because I have a feeling rebase can help with that. But what if no changes were introduced to that shared mainline branch as we were developing our feature branch? Well, instead of a three-way merge, we'd get what's called a fast forward merge. Fast forward merges happen when the feature branch is already anchored off the latest changes. You still have to take into account the tips of both branches, here and here, but since the branch is built off of the latest commit, there's a sequential history from the tip of that main branch all the way up to the tip of the feature branch, and no merge conflicts are possible. So when I run merge, Git simply will move that head pointer from the tip of mainline all the way to the tip of my feature branch, resulting in that feature branch being essentially absorbed into mainline. The original branch fades away, but the commits stay where they are, and we have a nice linear history. Let me go ahead and demonstrate this. I'll open up my terminal and run merge. You'll notice Git will tell me I've performed a fast forward merge in the output of the command. Plus, I don't actually have to specify a commit message because there's no merge commit. A fast forward merge is a lot cleaner and more straightforward than a three-way merge, but we do lose some historical detail since there is actually no merge commit and our branch was absorbed. But if you prefer to keep that feature branch around just for documentation purposes, just pass the no fast forward flag to the command like this, and Git will construct a merge commit regardless of if it's able to be fast forwarded or not. But keep fast forwarding in mind because this will be important later on. Now that we know about merges, and I've teased it enough, how does rebase compare and why would I use it in the first place? Well, first I'd like to point out that these animations and live coding examples are looking pretty nice, right? Well, what you're seeing is a sneak peek of the enhanced animations of my upcoming learngit.io service. If you want to join the waitlist at waitlist.learngit.io, you'll get monthly updates. And when you'll sign up, you get access to all the updates that I've done in the past. Trust me, there's pretty cool stuff in there. But anyways, let's get back to rebase. Well, let's go back to our original example. Let's say we want to take advantage of rebase in this situation instead of merge. We can use rebase to incorporate our collaborators' changes into our feature branch. To do this, I'll hop over into my terminal, but this time I'm going to check out my feature branch. I'll then run git rebase main. When this command executes, Git will start by simply setting aside those feature branch commits in a temporary holding area. After that, Git's going to sequentially copy each commit one by one and replay it on top of the latest commit from main. The original commits are then deleted. The result is that I've actually re-anchored my feature branch off of the latest changes from main, and in the process, incorporated my collaborator's changes into my work, since my work's now based off those changes. There's an important thing to notice about this picture too. Our history is now linear, and there's a single path from our anchor point all the way up to the tip of that feature branch. This means fast forward merging is on the table. No complex merge commits, just clean, linear project history when I'm ready to ship my feature. This type of rebase, when used in conjunction with fast forward merging, is the most common rebase workflow. It allows changes to be integrated incrementally instead of all at once, and enables developers to ensure compatibility with the latest changes, but in the safety of your own branch. Now, if I were to illustrate a merge-only workflow and compare that side-by-side with the rebase and merge workflow, you can see just how much cleaner a rebased history really is. This is the primary benefit of using it. But before you get ahead of yourself, rebase isn't all sunshine and rainbows. Rebase avoids merge commits, but it isn't magic. You can still have conflicts. As you can see, if your feature branch changes are incompatible with the branch you're rebasing, the operation will fail and you'll need to fix any conflicts. If you're gonna get a conflict when you merge, you're gonna get that same conflict when you rebase. But I'm gonna cover conflicts in an upcoming video, and I'm gonna link that video here and at the end of this video when it goes live. But besides conflicts, there is one other critical thing to know about rebase before you go out and start using it. You see, Git considers all commits immutable, which means they cannot be changed once they're created. That also means that during rebase, when Git grabs those commits, sets them aside, and replays them, the commits that end up on our newly re-anchored branch are actually copies of their originals. You can see that if I run the Git log before and after the rebase, the commit hashes are actually different. This signals to Git that these commits are brand new and have not been seen before in project history. At this point, you may be asking yourself, well, I mean, so what if they're copies? The commits contain the same changes as the originals, so, I mean, who cares if they're copies or not? Well, that's a kind of a good question, and the answer is that sometimes it actually doesn't matter, but sometimes it really does matter. If the branch you're rebasing is local only and not shared with other contributors, sure, yeah, no, go ahead and rebase. There's not a ton of risk there. But what if that branch is shared? In that case, you might want to rethink using rebase, and I'll give you an example of why. So say our feature branch is shared with another collaborator, and I'm just going to annotate the commits in this example for clarity. Now, let's say a third collaborator pushed a change to main, and you're going to both pull that change down. Now, say your collaborator just continues to work on that feature branch and add some commits, but you run rebase to re-anchor and integrate that latest change onto your feature branch first. Okay, so now we've got a problem. You've abandoned the original commits and created brand new ones, but your coworker hasn't. Both of your feature branches, even though they're technically the same branch, have diverged and contain a completely different set of commits as far as Git is concerned. Integrating your work together when it comes time is going to be challenging. Now, this is a pretty simplistic example, but these common scenarios become unwieldy when branches are shared due to rebase's deletion and rewriting of history. It's also the reason why it's not best practice to use rebase to move branches onto main. In fact, many repositories just prevent that behavior in the first place for that reason. But at the end of the day, I think the documentation does the best job of summing it up. Do not rebase commits that exist outside of your repository and that people may have based work on. If you follow that guideline, you'll be fine. Now that you know the inner workings of both rebase and merge, you've probably noticed merge and rebase aren't really competitors. They're teammates. Integrating both into your Git tool belt while keeping an eye out for pitfalls is what, you know, efficient programming is all about. And if I were to summarize this video in just one sentence, it would be this. Use rebase to re-anchor your feature branch to keep up with the latest changes. Then use merge to move those changes back onto shared branches. It's that simple. Now, Git experts among you may have noticed that I simplified some of the examples and diagrams in this video for the sake of clarity. But if you'd like a deep dive into anything I left out, just leave me a comment. Also subscribe. Peace.